Well, as we've heard, New South Wales recorded 13 new cases today, far fewer than Victoria's count. So is it too soon to be bringing back tougher restrictions, given how much they would hurt the economy? Angela Cox has been crunching the numbers, and Ange, the COVID curve is back.
Yes, it is, Mel. It's been a while, but I wanted to show you just how quickly New South Wales could be in the same position as its southern neighbour. This is how Victoria's curve looks. Let's go back to mid-June when things started really kicking off again. On the 15th of June, the state recorded 12 cases. Fast forward just a few short weeks, and today Victoria recorded its second biggest daily increase ever. 26 people are so sick they're in ICU, 21 on ventilators. Now let's have a look at New South Wales. You can see after a bad start, it's been tracking well, but today more than a dozen cases. And significantly, most of them are community transmissions, not returned travellers from overseas in quarantine. If New South Wales does nothing by early August, it could be right where Victoria is now. And remember, experts say once you hit 100 new community transmissions, it's extremely difficult to control the outbreak. So as hard as it might be to face restrictions again, acting sooner rather than later will likely mean less pain in the long run.
Thanks, Angela. For more on this, let's go to epidemiologist and World Health Organization member, Marylouise McLaws. Marylouise, good evening to you. Looking at these numbers, what do you think? Should New South Wales follow Victoria's lead and look at a lockdown?
Look, New South Wales numbers, if you take out the return travellers from New South Wales numbers, we have been doing remarkably well. And I don't think that we would benefit from a lockdown at the moment.
OK. Have there been mistakes made by Victoria that the rest of Australia could learn from to control this new outbreak?
One of the things that outbreak management learns rapidly, and that is act proactively. Don't wait until it's too late. So while I've said I don't think New South Wales or Sydney is ready for a lockdown, I think more importantly is focusing on how they've got it and which social venues they potentially picked it up and focus on those.
Yeah, that absolutely makes sense. One of the big things we've talked a lot about is wearing masks. Do you think it should be mandatory for anyone in any of these hot zones then to wear a mask?
Look, absolutely. One of the things as an outbreak manager I would have done was make masks mandatory in Melbourne and, if we get to that level, in Sydney.
Is this going to get better before it gets worse, or are we going to see another surge before things even out? I mean, where are we at?
For Melbourne, I was hoping that they would have peaked yesterday or today, but they haven't. So we've got to give them another either incubation period, another 5 days potentially, before we can potentially see a levelling out in New South Wales and in Sydney. The human contact tracers have a big challenge on their hand because they've got 20 people over the last couple of days. They have to do at least interviews with at least 200 people or more. So that's a very big challenge. But because we've had such low numbers in the background, I think they'll be able to meet that challenge very well. So on the one hand, yes, and on the other hand, in Melbourne, it's going to be tough.
Just quickly before I let you go, one final question. I feel like we're all in this state where we felt that things were improving. Maybe we're becoming a little complacent. A lot of people aren't. Most people aren't wearing masks. What is your advice to us all?
So it's absolutely every individual's responsibility to try to cooperate and don't second guess the rules, because it's a nasty virus. It loves lots of people socializing, and that's when you let your guard down. Please don't. If you're feeling at all unwell, stay at home, get tested, wear a mask.
Great advice. Marylouise McLaws, thank you.